live from the Summit in Houston, Texas. The Houston Rockets are about to play the biggest game in this city's history.
When I first took over this job, you walk around the city and you watch the kids, and they're wearing Chicago Bulls, all these other jerseys.
Game 7 for the NBA championship. Winner takes all.
The kids in Houston should love the Houston Rockets. And if I can make this city proud of this basketball team and then go out and win a championship, it'd be a heck of an accomplishment.
1, 2, 3, Rockets, go!
For the city of Houston, they're starving for a championship. So it's going to be the most incredible, almost going to be overwhelming that you accomplish something that no other team in that city has ever accomplished.
It all ends tonight, one way or the other, here in Houston.
I want to be part of the team that bring the fourth championship to Houston. I've been here for 13 years now. I've played all my career here. I just want to be part of it.
As the Rockets entered the 1993-94 season, they were more focused than ever on their goal of bringing a title to Houston. A season ago, under new coach Rudy Tomjanovich, they had tasted playoff success for the first time since 1987.
The Houston Rockets beat the Los Angeles Clippers to advance.
And though they would lose to Seattle in a tough 7-game series in the conference semifinals, it would prove to be a vital step in their evolution.
The Rockets always been labeled as a team that they have a lot of talent, but did not play hard every night. But I think the Seattle series was probably the turning point.
Houston with a chance to tie or win it. Maxwell to Smith. Overtime. Off the rim. At the buzzer.
A few bounce balls. If we win that series and we go on to play Phoenix and have a chance to win it all. So that really changed our thinking. We thought of ourselves as winners.
Rudy Tomjanovich, what an agonizing time. Your team playing remarkably well, rallying from last place a year ago to win the Midwest title in overtime, down to the final.
As they assembled for training camp, their resolve was clear.
We went down to Galveston. We wound up in an old high school gym, but the atmosphere was work ethic. You know, here we are in this little high school gym, and we're going to go to work. And right from the beginning, everybody is on the same page, and that's where we started. And that was the key, I think, to the success of this team.
From the season's opening game, the Rockets played with fierce intensity, led as always by Hakeem Olajuwon.
He is smooth, he is quick, he is agile.
Olajuwon wheeling and dealing.
What a spin move!
He's doing it all.
But now Hakeem not only spearheaded the Rockets' offense, he would also ensure that it would be more than a one-man attack.
Great balance with everybody involved.
Instead of competing with one another, now we're complementing one another. So we're playing together as a team.
And as Olajuwon distributed the ball, the Rockets unveiled one of the league's deadliest long-range attacks.
Three-pointer for Mario Elie.
Rudy was saying in the beginning of the season, that was going to be our biggest weapon because we had really good three-point shooters in them. And once we're knocking down the three and get our inside-outside game going, we're hard to beat.
Rockets are in tune with each other.
Maxwell set for another three. Maxwell.
They are on fire.
Kenny Smith sets for the three. Get in there. Yes.
Well, if the right one don't get you, the left one will.
When we're hitting our shots, when we're hitting our threes, and we're on a roll, you just can't stop us.
And early on, the Rockets were unstoppable as they began the season with the league's longest winning streak.
They have been unbeatable this year.
Smith for three. 14 in a row. How sweet it is.
And as they headed to New York to face the Knicks, they looked to tie an NBA record by winning a 15th consecutive game.
It's electric here in the Garden. The Houston Rockets at 14-0. The Rockets trying to make some NBA history tonight in the Big Apple.
They say in New York, it was in the papers, not in our house.
The Rockets had been pointing towards this night all season as their first big test. But while the Knicks made brash statements to the media, the Rockets were quietly confident.
The media hyped it up, saying the Knicks was going to stop our streak, but I can see it in the guys' eyes that we wasn't going to lose. And we knew at that time that the Knicks didn't have a chance.
The game was never a contest. The Rockets would not only tie the record, but also send notice to the rest of the league that they were legitimate contenders.
The Houston Rockets going to a record of 15-0, and they do it in impressive fashion.
It's one of the great wins in Houston Rocket history.
Houston would go on to win 22 of their first 23 games, the second best mark in NBA history, and they would never lose that momentum. Even during stretches when their high-powered offense seemed to cool, they found other ways to win.
Robert Horry blocks the shot, blocks it again. Oh, boy, what hustle by Houston.
And we play hard defense, get on people's face, and we play against any other team, and we shut them down.
Barkley goes to KJ, and Larry shot.
Hakeem would go on to be named Defensive Player of the Year, and Houston would be recognized as possessing one of the league's toughest defenses.
We were going out, holding people under 100 points, keeping people down, and that was the key, the defense. But then we had different guys stepping up at different times.
Throughout the season, it seemed that whenever the Rockets needed a big play, they always found a way to get it.
An impossible, implausible, incredible three-point play by Vernon Maxwell.
The game's close, and we just grit our teeth and go out and do whatever it takes to get the win. And you can just see it in us. You know, when we walk on the floor late in the ball game, we're just so confident that we're going to win the game.
Maxwell, 1 second. Did he get it in time? Yes!
Houston compiled the second-best record in the NBA and the best in franchise history. And heading into the playoffs, they were fully ready for the challenge ahead of them.
I think just going through this year has built our character and confidence because we have a team that really believe in one another.
Houston's first place division finish earned them a matchup with a struggling Portland Trailblazer team. But the Rockets were taking nothing for granted.
Coming into the Portland series is kind of scary because you're playing against a team, a veteran team, that's been to the finals a couple years in a row, and you know, heart-wise and talent-wise, that you're going to be faced with, you know, a real good team.
If the once powerful Blazers had dreams of recapturing past playoff glory, Hakeem put them quickly to rest as he scored at will against an overmatched Portland front line.
You know, they had Chris Dudley guarding him, and you know, Chris is supposed to be a good post defender.
Oh, you can't stop him.
And he just couldn't do anything with him. And there were times when the bench was going crazy, and Chris would look over there at us with frustration on his face, you know, and we would tell him, don't worry about it, Chris. You know, it's not your fault.
Taking over at both ends of the floor, Hakeem dominated the first two games. And as the series shifted to Portland, with the Rockets leading 2-0, the Blazers desperately looked for inspiration.
It's not going to be the guy who scores the most points going to win this series. This team is going to win the series. The best team is going to win the series. The best team is us.
Portland's plan was simple. Swarm Hakeem on every play.
They're going to try to wear him down. They're going to beat on him.
And their strategy seemed to work as they managed to stave off elimination in Game 3. But Houston knew what had to be done.
We saw that different periods of the game, he was real tired. And, you know, I mean, we had to give him a little bit more help stepping up on offense also because it was pounding him so much that we would, somebody else had to step up the offensive game.
Banding together, the Rockets would now finish what Hakeem had begun.
Kenny Smith, yes!
We're thinking, let's not cheat ourselves, because this team has taken the team concept to another level. We wanted to get past the Portland as a team.
With all the Rockets contributing in Game 4, Houston easily left the Trailblazers in their dust. But as they looked ahead to the next round, they knew that the Phoenix Suns would pose a far greater challenge.
Well, we put a lot of pressure on ourselves when that series rolled around because Seattle was out of it by then. We felt like we had the home court throughout the playoffs, and we feel like we win all our home games from here on out. We win it.
As Game 1 began in Houston, the Rockets hoped that home court advantage would give them the edge against the defending Western Conference champion, Suns.
Go Rockets!
And at first it did, as they jumped out to a commanding lead.
How do you stop it? You just can't stop it. Maxwell! Maxwell in the open court, 3-on-1 fast break. Here's Ory!
But as the game wore on, Houston would suddenly falter.
And Smith lost it, but he lost the dribble. And a steal by Marley. He'll step back behind the three-point line, and all of that hard work to go right down the drain. Marley short on the three, and comes right back to him.
Bingo. The long rebound has really hurt Houston.
Oh! Olajuwon was wide open. Maxwell missed him by 40 feet. The Phoenix Suns, they upset the Rockets at home in Game 1. Phoenix now has the home court advantage.
Having squandered their cherished home court advantage, Houston was left searching for answers.
We played good enough to win. We had the lead. But going back to the locker room, still cannot understand or explain or justify how we lost that game. We know we were supposed to win.
In the second game, the Rockets again built a seemingly insurmountable lead.
Robert Ory with another block shot. That's his third of the game. Kenny Smith takes it inside. Back to Robert. The Rockets are just stampeding the Phoenix Suns. Here we go to the final 12 minutes. The Rockets leading at 100-82.
But again, the fourth quarter would see Houston mysteriously unravel.
Vernon has KJ to work on. Takes it to the middle, has it blocked. Otis Thorpe picks it up. Goes inside, has it blocked by Barkley. If somebody doesn't step up and make a basket here pretty soon, kind of like a plague, you know, it just starts to take over the entire team.
Who's going to take the shot for the Rockets beside Olajuwon? They're going to double and triple team him. They're not going to give him the shot.
Rockets haven't scored in a week.
Rockets need a stop. 38 seconds left. It's tied at 108. The Phoenix Suns have come from 20 points down to tie the game.
Houston must feel like the roof is coming in.
Unbelievable collapse here by Houston.
The most embarrassing thing was to lose that big lead that we had there in the fourth period. Just the way we came out, the way we shot the ball, the way we executed, the way we played defense. I thought it was very pitiful at that time.
The Phoenix Suns in a remarkable come-from-behind victory.
There isn't anybody over there who wants to shoot. So when Akeem got it, we were all over him like that cheap suit you got.
Very tough defeat to take. Had control of the game for most of it, and it hurts.
The Rockets with backs to the wall. That is an understatement going into that America West Arena in Phoenix down 0-2.
We're stunned. Nobody couldn't believe it, you know. I thought it was over with.
We heard all the negatives, Choke City, no way they're coming back. Charles Barkley said they may sweep.
You can feel the anger inside. You can feel everything inside that everybody wanted to come out and just give their all because no way we was going to go out without a fight.
Houston was in desperate need of a spark, and in Game 3, that's exactly what they get.
Olajuwon swings it around. Here's Maxwell, the three. And here he comes. Vernon Maxwell. That's a three for Vernon Maxwell, who's heating up here.
Well, it might be Vernon Maxwell's night to step up.
I just told him to kick the ball up to me and let me break down the defense before it gets set. And I got my confidence going. It was on from there. I definitely felt confident. It was going to be tough for anybody to stop me on that night.
Maxwell, three.
right now taking over this ball game.
Vernon, another three.
Yes! Oh, Mike!
I've never seen anything like it.
This is one of the gutsy performances in Rocket history.
Maxwell had lit their fuse, and the Rockets would never come back to Earth. Emphatically winning Game 3, they would change the entire complexion of the series.
It was just amazing how the momentum just switched, and I just see Barkley and KJ just, the look in their faces, they just couldn't believe what was going on.
The Rockets would take two of the next three games from the reeling Suns and enter a decisive seventh game, brimming with confidence.
We felt like we was gonna win. It's one of those things where you walk in the locker room, you can just feel the confidence of each and every player in there.
It's an opportunity, and we were not about to misuse it.
And Hakeem would make sure that they wouldn't, as he launched a one-man barrage against the still reeling Suns.
Here's Hakeem with the spin. Oh, what a move. Hakeem Olajuwon, 37 points, 17 rebounds, three blocked shots.
And with rookie Sam Cassell joining the attack, Houston was simply unstoppable.
Shot clock at one. Cassell. Oh, three by Cassell. He has 20. And they are celebrating at the Houston bench. Olajuwon. Yes, and it counts. And that will do it. The Houston Rockets on their way to the Western Conference Final.
Emphatically dispatching the Suns, the Rockets would surge into the Western Conference Finals more confident than ever.
I think the first games we lost was a blessing in disguise because it brought us closer together. This chemistry that we have now, if we maintain it, we go all the way.
Hakeem, I'm here representing millions and millions of basketball fans around the world to tell you that you've had a spectacular NBA career. You've led your team to its best season ever. You're a certain Hall of Famer, and you do it with an elegance and a grace that's spectacular. Congratulations on being the 1994 NBA Most Valuable Player.
Even though they awarded me as the MVP, I couldn't have done it without my teammates. So what can I do to let them know I really appreciate their effort, that we all did this together. So I requested for them to help me accept this award because they're part of it. You know, they are the one that really make it happen.
As you know, basketball is a team sport. And I'd like to extend my gratitude to my teammates for their contributions in making this happen. Thank you very much. And my coaches, thank you very much.
You know, he deserved the award, but he's showing his teammates, you were the guys that helped me get it. And I was just tingling with a gesture like that. And just can't explain what a wonderful rush that was.
That moment would provide the defining image for the Western Conference Finals. Facing the Utah Jazz, the Rockets displayed their unselfish philosophy in its finest form and turned the series into a showcase for their team unity.
Totally unselfish is how I would describe how Houston is playing right now.
It's a matter of someone stepping up, and every night someone was willing to do that.
Kenny Smith on fire tonight. He's hit 5 3-point field goals.
Smith.
That carries over. You know, people after that game will go, well, maybe next game, tomorrow night, it'll be my turn. And I'll try to do something to make it my turn.
Maxwell, the long jumper, good.
Oh, Vernon Maxwell's on fire tonight.
We're shooting with a lot of confidence, and we're shooting well, and we're playing well. And it's going to be tough for anybody to beat us in that series.
Olajuwon low left against Felton Spencer. Kenny Smith off to Ellie, a three from the right. Good. Shaking his fist, exhorting the crowd.
Olajuwon, he's 15 makes. He lane, jumps it up from 10 court.
Yes, that's 41 points for the Green.
Jake move now to Orient from the right. No!
Oh, what a shot by Robert Orient! Explosion, an explosion.
Sellout crowd in the Summit coming to its feet. A 22.
2-point lead for Houston.
The Rockets would soar past the Jazz in five games and enjoy doing it.
They can smell it now in the Summit in Houston. A Western Conference title.
Wrapping up the series at home, they celebrated their greatest playoff achievement since 1986.
How sweet it is! 3-1, Houston wins the West. Houston going to the NBA Finals for its third time in history. 81, 86, and now 94.
The day the Rockets had worked for all year was finally at hand. The first game of the finals had arrived, and it was being played at home in Houston.
Game one, the NBA Finals from the Summit in Houston.
It's going to be a great series. I think it's going to be great for the fans.
The Rockets' third trip to the NBA Finals. This is the seventh for the New York Knicks.
NBA Finals program. It's the Rockets program.
We just have to go out and do what we've done all year.
Not since 1969, when Russell and Chamberlain concluded their epic struggles, has the matchup at center been so much at the heart of an NBA final.
Well, this is a championship game, so you have more just, you know, playing against Patrick. So it's an opportunity to bring something unique to the city.
But if the Rockets were going to bring home a championship to Houston, they would have to survive their quest's most grueling challenge. In 1984, Ewing had defeated Olajuwon in the NCAA Finals, and now he led a Knick team that closely matched the Rockets in drive and determination.
This place is already hopping. Olajuwon inside, he's fouled and goes!
As the game began, both teams burst out of the gate.
We can play aggressive.
But it was the Rockets who would set the pace.
Smith for Maxwell. Maxwell all the way.
And although Houston could not shake New York, the game's tempo was theirs, and their offense ran with deadly precision.
Beautiful move by Akeem.
As the half raced to a close, the Knicks would be unable to keep pace, leaving the confident Rockets with an 8-point lead. In the second half, the Knicks would change the game's style, and with it, the momentum.
Rebound Mason. Head fake. One dribble. Another head fake. Lefty layup. It's good. And a foul.
Right there. Mario Elie and Oakley. Bang, bang. Both of them.
Ewing stopped by Olajuwon. Ewing on the recovery. Smith. And tiptoe.
With the game approaching its final minutes, the fired up Knicks would push the Rockets to the brink of a demoralizing home court defeat.
The Rocket lead is only three.
And to say they're a bit nervous in Houston would be an understatement.
The Rockets now braced themselves for the task ahead. Their mission was clear.
Right now, we gotta get the rebound. Five guys getting in there. Every rebound is ours. Every rebound is ours.
Matching the Knicks' intensity, the Rockets would now beat them at their own game.
Oakley keeps it alive. Ewing with the tip. Olajuwon gets to it. Knicks working it around. Here's Ewing for three. And it's rebounded by Ewing.
Choking off New York shooters, Houston would literally grab back control of the game.
Well, the crowd is finally back into the game. And they're trying to urge the Rockets on.
Knicks starting to throw up bricks now, wishing they were swishing.
All that was left was the knockout blow.
They switch it around. Robert Horry puts it up. Oh, Robert Horry with a three!
And the Rockets would deliver it with an exclamation point.
On the top of the 12-9, a 6-point lead by New York.
An emotional first win belonged to Houston, and they were fully enjoying it.
Three more to go, baby. Three more.
Pressure's still on us. Got to get this game. It's the biggest game of the year right now coming up. We get two, then we get three chances to steal, and we'll keep the home court advantage. It's big. It's big, and our minds got to be right. Get your rest. Get your minds right.
Let's go, fellas.
Close it out. We got to play better.
One, two, three, Rockets!
Houston had turned back New York's charge in game one, but they knew that the Knicks had not unleashed all their weapons.
Game plans for number two here tonight. Knicks just have to shoot the ball better. They had a lot of open shots. They've got to knock them down.
And New York's guards would quickly make Houston's worst fears a reality.
Starting for a three-pointer, he puts it in.
As they bombarded the Rockets from all sides.
Hopper for three, yes.
The Knicks guards continue to ignite them.
Ewing down low is double team. Cross-court pass, he's Oakley underneath the Smith, and he jams it in.
The Knicks are red hot. It leads to a Houston timeout.
Knicks just triggering everything. Rockets, Joe, in trouble.
Hang in there, guys. Come on, guys, let's make a run from here. Let's go. Pressure on the ball. Pressure on the ball.
You got to expect pressure. Expect pressure.
While the Knicks knew what was coming, they could do nothing to stop it.
Maxwell off the steal from Sam Cassell. Smith takes it to the basket, protected by Elijah Wong. And the Rockets are rolling. Able to work his way around Ewing.
Out front, the Maxwell flashes to the basket. Kicks it out to Bullard for a three. Not at the side. Bullard hits the three and ties the score.
3-point play, and the Rockets have taken over here on the court.
We're going to win it at this end, though. Let's get the ball inside.
The Rockets had pushed their way back into the game, and now they look to Hakeem to win it for them. But the Knicks' defense would disrupt their plan.
Starts with the steal, and Mason has a breakaway.
Clamping down on Houston, New York would overwhelm them in the fourth quarter.
Harper in the front court, pulls up, 15-footer. He drops it in. Maxwell lobs it in the paint. Elijah Wan head fake, puts up the shot, blocked by Ewing.
And the Rockets could only helplessly watch as the Knicks stole the game, and with it, the precious home court advantage.
Harper with a monster game, and we're all even at one game apiece, heading to New York for games 3, 4, and 5 from the Garden.
We lost the home court advantage, so we're pushed in the deep into the corner, but maybe that's what this team needs.
They are certainly ready here at Madison Square Garden for game 3, Knicks and the Rockets.
We lose one, now we've got to go to New York, and their confidence has got to be up.
Elijah Wan's going to be
New
quiet.
York's in the house, New York.
Have to admit, our confidence was shaken a little bit.
Boom, the Knicks win. They're going to win it in 5, Houston.
Game 2, that was something that really hurt us. And you're talking about home court advantage.
Go New York, go!
We knew at that time we had to get it back. The pressure was put right back in our laps.
They're not ready for this. This is where it happens. This is where you have championships. You don't get it in Houston.
Houston is really looking at this as a very, very big game. They feel if New York gets some momentum, especially with this home crowd, that New York may be on a train that's impossible to stop.
Hey, Patrick, try to get in the circle tonight on the jump ball, okay? I don't know, it might just be a ritual with you, but...
Back in Madison Square Garden, the Knicks seemed relaxed and confident. New York's home court advantage had been highly touted, and the Knicks looked to give the Rockets a first-hand demonstration. Houston, however, had different ideas.
Underneath, wide open, fourth, and he thunders at home. All right, jump pass out front to Corey. Pitches to Maxwell. Maxwell around, starts to the basket, puts up the runner and scores. Nice move from right to left.
Houston doing everything right.
Into way, offhand, baseline, TikTok, a hook.
Playing ferociously on both ends of the floor, Houston gave New York little to cheer about.
Up, turns toward the baseline, lost it, picks it up, shot blocked by Elijah Wan.
That up, corner zone pass, that way. He did not hit it.
So far, the Knicks not executing anything at all the way they did in game 2.
Right here is where you do it. This is where you demoralize them.
And the Rockets extend to a 14-point lead.
And the Rockets are laying it on.
Meanwhile,
the Knicks are in a bit of a desperate time.
Now, two or three stops in a row. Now, come on, go, go.
With the game winding down, the Knicks looked for a way to break the Rockets' stranglehold, and they would pin their hopes on their greatest weapon.
Harper all over him like a wet shirt out front. Almost blocking again. Harper dives on the floor.
With Houston's offense ground to a halt, the Knicks drove back into the game.
Right to start. Bounce pass down the right side. Beautifully. And jamming it home was Bonner, and he was fouled.
That might have been what the Knicks needed to really get them started.
Let's go.
But the Knicks looking for one of those fourth quarter comebacks.
Ahead to Harper. Two on one. Harper takes it all the way and scores.
A three-pointer, no good, short. Oakley the rebound. Outlet to Starks. One man to beat. Starks with the layup. It's good. And the game is tied at 77.
The Rockets had wasted a commanding lead. Now this pivotal game would be decided in the final minutes by a battle of wills.
Execution to win it right now. Execution. The Rockets are going to have to make something happen here. Sam Cassell on the forecourt. Remember, the Knicks have never led. Sam all the way to the basket. Up,
yes!
Up, doing the foul. What a drive by Sam Cassell.
And that is their first field goal in 10 and a half minutes.
The game on the line, the score tied. Shot clock at 7, up top to Harper. Harper penetrates, pulls up, 20-foot jumper. He puts it in. Knicks back up by 2.
And the Knicks have come all the way back.
And this series has come to this. It would be excruciating and devastating to the team that loses this game.
Rockets need a field goal desperately here.
48 seconds left. The Rockets down by 2.
It has come down to this.
Elijah Wan spins inside on Ewing. Kicks it out back to Cassell.
Here's Cassell for 3.
Bingo! The rookie hit it.
Wow, big shot by Cassell.
One poise by the rookie out of Florida State.
And the Rockets win game 3. They gained back the home court advantage.
You couldn't ask him to make a bigger shot than that. And he knocked it in just like it was routine. And I was just so proud of the guy. I mean, it was a guts play.
The rookie from Florida State, with all the weight of the world on his shoulders, buried the big three.
The Knicks now really have to probably win the next 2 here in order to have a legitimate shot going back to the final 2 if needed.
Yes, I know there's a big time pressure on them, because if we get one more here, we're going back home and it'll be trouble.
We're feeling pretty good about ourselves, and we should. We did a hell of a job. But we can't let these guys get back into it, and we don't want to go back home 2-3.
Like Rudy say, let's stick together, let's do this together, man. We did it all year together, let's do it now.
One, two, three, Rockets!
Having regained control of the series, the Rockets were intent on keeping it. But over the next 2 games, they would find themselves haunted by the same mysterious breakdowns that had plagued them throughout the playoffs.
Oh, he looked left and kept right on going.
Nice pump fake by Harper.
Outlet to Maxwell already in the front court to Cassell. Knocked away, stolen by Mason. And here comes Mason with the dribble in the other way. Ahead to Starks. Down low to Bonner, and he banks in the layup.
Games 4 and 5 would follow nightmarishly similar patterns as the Rockets seemed unable to get their offense in gear.
And Maxwell, 3 of 18 outside the arc. There's a steal by Oakley. They cut in front of Thorpe, high post right. Rockets looking all around, looking at each other. They don't know what's happening.
As the Knicks now gained confidence on their home floor, the bewildered Rockets seemed always to be struggling to get back into the game.
Rockets are in a dogfight, scratching and clawing and trying to stay alive.
Knicks doing what they have to do, being aggressive on D.
Though Houston would make valiant comebacks in each contest, the Knicks frustrated them when it counted most.
Just like that, you snap your fingers, and the Knicks are back on top.
Starks to the right wing. Fires up a 3. Bang!
We are now seeing an inspired effort.
two crucial wins would belong to the Knicks.
Stark puts a spike in the heart of the Rockets.
And as they headed back to Houston, the Rockets had to wonder if they had left their chances of winning a championship in New York.
The Knicks are going to be one win away from their first NBA championship in 21 years.
One win away.
Tonight, Game 6, the 1994 NBA Finals. Rockets, the Dream, all backs to the wall.
And it has come down to this for the Rockets. They must win at home tonight or spend the summer contemplating what might have been.
Indeed, this is a must for the Rockets. To get to Game 7, you got to go through Game 6. The Knicks, if they win it, will have the championship in 94.
Guard play has been so vital in this series. The Knicks guards have outplayed the Houston Rocket guards, no question there.
Now, I got to believe Kenny Smith, some kind of way, has got to get out of the doldrums. Derek Harper knows he's got him in his pocket, and Kenny Smith thinks that he's in Derek's pocket.
But these are the moments, the championship moments, that define the great players. The guys that are born to play basketball and who live every moment of their lives for these championship moments.
Back in Houston, the Rockets desperately hoped that playing on their own court would provide the answer to their problems. But early on, it was the Knicks guards who seemed at home.
And here comes Starks. Oh, what a move by John Starks.
Continuing their relentless assault, they dominated Houston's backcourt on both ends of the floor.
Maxwell turns it over. Oh, my goodness.
The Knicks get an easy one.
The guards just not getting it done for Houston at all here.
And Derek. Take care of that damn basketball. Damn, it's killing us.
In urgent need of a lift, the Rockets would look to their bench, and they would quickly deliver.
Herrera on the drive. On the run again. Here comes Cassell, accelerating and hitting. Sam Cassell.
It's out top to Sam Cassell. Sam,
backdoor, Olajuwon slam dunk. What a pass by Sam Cassell.
Carl Herrera has been feeling it inside and outside as it seems he can do no wrong against the New York Knicks.
What a job Herrera and Cassell have done off the bench.
Ignited by their reserves, the Rockets starters found new life and helped Houston decisively take over the game.
Back out to Vernon, three-pointer, Dominic.
Yes! A big one for Max. Boy, the Rockets really just taking control.
As the Knicks had done to them in games 4 and 5, Houston now forced New York to play from behind. But despite their advantage, the Rockets knew that the Knicks' most dangerous run was yet to come.
Steal number 4 for Derek Harper, and he set up John Starks.
And just about the time you want to put him away, the Knicks are hanging around, trailing by 6.
The Knicks' furious comeback would all but erase the Rockets' lead, leaving Houston in grave danger of having their championship hopes brutally crushed on their home floor. Heartened by their battles with Phoenix, the resilient Rockets would fight their way back into the game.
Starks takes it all the way, throws up a wild shot and banked it in!
Max,
oh,
but on this night, they would be tested to their very limits.
No! No! No!
With a red-hot John Starks carrying the Knicks, Houston found themselves locked in a frantic struggle to keep their championship quest alive.
Olajuwon!
Mason tries to muscle in on the right side, kicks it out back to Starks, open for a three, and he scores!
John Starks, unconscious here.
Nation, react! We have got to get the ball.
Charles Smith on the follow, and Lori able to sweep it. Fort with Starks back, feeding Maxwell. And the Knicks want to talk it over.
Clinging to a narrow lead with time running out, the Rockets looked for one decisive blow.
In there, Thorpe sets the pick and roll. He's got Thorpe left, posting up, turning. Kenny all alone, a three-pointer. Yes! Yeah! New York! Kenny Smith hits the biggest three-pointer of his career.
84-77 Houston, as Smith slammed the Rocket with a huge three.
As Hakeem snuffed out the Knicks' last desperate hope, Houston preserved one of the most dramatic victories in franchise history.
And the Rockets win! The ball was tipped. It was partially blocked.
And Elijah Wan, Joe, Elijah Wan with the big tip.
And it will go to a seventh and decisive game Wednesday.
One game away from
Live from the Summit in Houston, Texas, the Houston Rockets are about to play the biggest game in this city's history.
All the planning, all the practices, all the battles, and it comes down to just one basketball game.
This will be a championship determined by wills, but the question is, whose will it be?
Back in training camp, we set a goal, and that goal was to win the championship. It's taken a hell of a lot of hard work. We've been down in holes, and we dug out of them. And it doesn't make sense to do all this work and come this far and not close it out.
We have to give it all. I mean, that's what we say. We say, okay, now we're here. We overcome all the things that we had at the beginning in this series, and now we have to take it. We have to beat it. We have to beat them. We have to win it no matter what.
We got to do the things that got us here. Playing our game. Our game is good enough. We don't have to invent something different. We'll make some adjustments, but our game is good enough, and we've got to believe in it. We've got to believe in each other. We got to believe in the system because it's gotten us here.
I get phone calls from my good buddies, Tim Hardaway, Mitch Richmond, and they're like, man, you got a chance to get a ring. And these guys are just great players. They're all-star players, and they're calling me up telling me, you know, they don't care about being all-stars. They just want to wear that ring.
Is it going to be easy to get it? I just, through my experience, anything good in life, you have to work real hard for. There might be times when we get down, but like we've done all year, instead of pulling apart, we pull together, and we're going to get this thing done.
This is as close as we're going to get. You know, now we just have to finish it. You know, we know that we've gone through so many battles. We've won battles, we've lost battles, but we have not lost the war yet. It's going to take everybody, individual and collective effort, to bring it home.
They can't score on us, y'all. Let's go. Let's take it home. Let's take it home. Bring our championship home. 1, 2, 3.
This all-important game would prove to be a mirror of the Rockets' season.
Into the basket. Out front to Oring, who steps, doesn't take the three. Inside to a key, shovels back to Oring. Oh, he yeah.
Roaring out to a quick start, they would seize control from the beginning.
Maxwell for three. Yes! Good bounce pass down the right side to Elijah Wan. Got around Charles Smith. It's Tomahawks at home.
Yes, the Rockets are fired up.
And appropriately, everyone would play their part to perfection.
Kenny Smith with his best start in the NBA Finals.
Though New York would mount their challenges, Houston would rise to the occasion as they had so many times before, somehow finding an answer, no matter how improbable.
Cross court, he dumps the ball to Smith, off balance, fires, and banged in, a 30-footer! Oh, a Hail Mary was answered and he kissed the rainbow off the glass!
In this ultimate game, the Rockets would put on a championship performance that was the perfect testament to their will and determination.
And it's picked up by Smith. Starts 1 for 12. Long lob down court. Open Elijah Wan. Tomahawk jams it home.
Houston would at last have its title. And the Rockets would have a storybook ending to their inspirational season.
Maxwell, a three-pointer. Maxwell, yes!
Yes! My goodness.
And the Houston Rockets, led by Hakeem Olajuwon, are the world champions of 1994.
We have a unique team. Guys line one another, be more friends. You can see that the commitment, individual commitment, is not his team, it's our team.
The Rockets are NBA champions. Holy cow.
I think, you know, the image of this team that we will be in character will be the best, one of the best teams that Houston ever had. And in effort on the court will be the best also.
An NBA championship for Houston,
Texas. They're bothering themselves, how sweet it is.
The way they play, hard-nosed defense, unselfish, and then go out and win a championship. You know, that was my dream right from the beginning. And now to have done it, it's like a dream come true.
To the 1994 NBA World Champion. Yeah!
Houston, you wanted this for so long, you finally got it. I'm proud to be a part of the team that got it for you. And when I say team, I mean it in the true sense of the word. These guys went out and did it together. We've got the best player in the league, but we've got a lot of great players. We couldn't have did it if we didn't do it together.
Yeah, maybe next year. Yeah.